Now, reports coming in regarding our conversation this morning. Apparently, the East African Legislative Assembly Uganda representative, that is Dennis Namara, has petitioned court over the expiry of data bundles by telecom companies, a move that could trigger a debate on consumer protection measures by authorities. In a suit filed on November 15th at the High Court in Kampala Civil Division, Namara says his data bundles have been debited dubiously without explanation. He has sued Mobile Telecommunications Network, that is MTN, and Airtel Uganda. He accuses them of greed. Now, around 2016, consumers complained of practice by telecommunication firms, I beg your pardon, where firms resorted to deducting airtime from a consumer to browse the internet. Consumers protested the unjustified deductions, forcing telecom companies to innovate further. Telecom companies moved to create two accounts on the system, a data bundle and the main account for airtime, to address the problem. Additionally, consumers are also notified of how much of their data is used in the process. Why should your data bundle expire?
One, because of ignorance.
That is why it would expire.
That is why you think your data bundle expires.
Yeah, I mean, we have been comfortable over time for our data bundle to expire. Like, you know, you read back in the day when you loaded like 100 MBs and you had like a 5K of airtime, your 100 MBs would get done. They would not notify you or anything. They would
just keep
straight
going
into
airtime.
Until you find, hey,
even airtime,
swing as on as you were. And you were comfortable with it. Until some people said, look, why should you take my data, then go into my airtime without my permission? Then those guys also, you know, innovated and said, okay, now, if your data gets expired, we notify you. And if you want to buy, you can use your airtime to buy. But now the question is, why should I buy 1 GB for 3 days?
When
you understand?
When we both know
I can use 1 GB for 5 days.
Thank you.
So now that's the conversation, which I think, because when you reach the third day, that's where you find, you know, people going into porn sites because they want to use up their data. They send videos and what, you know, because they want to use the 1 GB. But that's all wasted, you understand? And I think it was Kalinati or someone on Twitter who said, do you find these telecom companies, guys wearing helmets and whatnot and pouring away the data that has not been used?
I know, right, in the morning.
Where does the data go?
And that's what, and I think this guy has addressed it, because leave alone the data expiring, like they've interviewed in this country, we're just used, we're accustomed to living like that.
Okay.
Things happen the way they do. But you can have the data expiration thing. It's a package that should last you at least until the time it gets done. Because if I have spent my 5K to buy 1 GB, I have already given you the 5K. Let me use my entire GB. Don't tell me I take 2 days, because that is the bundle you have what? Paid for. Another thing that bothers me is how our data, it's like there's someone siphoning data off our phones when you're sleeping. And I did this personally. I went to sleep. All my apps were not running, right? But I left the data running. So, of course, you're going to wake up at Jacobo, because it's like what? 20 MBs?
Ningos, because it says that. It's similar to
no, cookies and all of that. There's some stuff that keeps running on your phone.
Okay.
Naya nozuku kanga wale seko 3 GB. In the morning, I got up and no lie, honest to God, nasanga ko 1.2 GB.
No iPhone, where is it? You?
No. I know.
iPhone, where to
manage? No, I know it. I know.
Is your background data on?
Yes, I know.
That's
my,
why.
I know
it
when
consumes
my background,
a lot of data.
Listen, I know when my background data is on, and I know how to turn off my background data. Now I'm telling you, background data was off. But you just try it. Kemera kati your data right
for
now.
For me, the thing is, I've
what do I background data? Kati na techno.
Zina.
Zine vizivava tabira. Kati vetuwa tuwa na genzo kwe wakanga nina 3 GB, nenzo kanga nina 1 GB. Noga, oh, my iPhone.
Techno too.
For me, techno.
For me, I, you know, would want to talk about the principle rather than the mistakes that happen while we are, you know, transacting data with these companies. Because okay. like it or not, even if they say data will no longer expire, those mistakes will be through. I remember there was a time when we were suffering with the MTN's Gonya. Mm. And man, they had a Gonya somewhere and it was just eating the data.
Mm.
You understand? But I think finally they solved it. I haven't experienced what Tina is talking about.
I have.
I you know, put on, and my data runs really comfortably well. But I know that there are people who are suffering that. Mm. People have complained. And me, I'm like, but how? How will they take your data like that? Because I'm in this, you know, place of the world. I think that the discussion should be now the principle. That when I buy my, you know, 5K, 1GB or 5GBs, like Tina has said, I give you my 5K, you take it.
Let me use mine.
Yeah, I've not said that when I use 500 MBs, you give me the balance. No. So why are you saying that my data will expire in 3 days?
Let me use the entire 5K.
Yeah, so that's where people are saying, look, these guys are just, you know, they're not thugs. Mm-hmm. They are making money because ignorance is no defense.
Of course.
Yeah, the fact that you didn't know that they could split your airtime account from your data account does not mean that, you know, you can't say, you can't pay any sense in that.
One would say that, you know, maybe these guys are greedy, like, you know, Namara is saying right here, because a couple of months ago, I think a year ago, you know, government came out with an enrollment of having Wi-Fi placed all over town. We had them, you know, dig cables where here and there and in the name of Wi-Fi. But at the end of the day, these are the telecom companies that are going to give us the Wi-Fi, the MTNs of today, the Airtels, you know, name it all. But they have, you know, somehow, somewhere delayed on, you know, as far as evolving to Wi-Fi is concerned.
For me,
wouldn't you think that they are actually benefiting more from this data?
Of course, just like any
they
other
are,
business,
like any
they
business.
Benefit. But for me, I think we lose the conversation when we try to demonize the other party. You understand? When we try to demonize them and say they are greedy
or anything,
we lose the conversation.
They're also trying to make a quick buck.
Yeah, because then I think that we need to have a sustainable solution, not just for us as our car generation, but also for people who are going to come and start using this data platform. When you were shifting from 3G to 4G, and they were saying, come and re-register, come with your national IDs, we complained. Why are you doing that? You're double registering us. Where is our data going? You thieves, you thugs. And then we used to have the critical conversations of, okay, should we move to the fact that our data should not expire? If we do that,
what are the consequences for us and
for them? Will the telecom companies stay in operation when we move to that? Because there's also that aspect of people are now going to start buying 1GB, kukekeleza it for 1 week. But there is some guy who's seated at that car machine in MTN or Airtel. Who is he going to get paid? How is he going to get paid? So those conversations need to be had where we, the consumers, are comfortably getting services, but also the other guys who are offering the service are not extorting us, but we are also not sort of taking a lot of
so it's, you prefer it to be more of a balanced economy.
Yeah, I think it should be a balanced conversation.
I think the only solution for that, and this is what burdens me about all these telecommunications companies that we have in this country, because they are all not originally from here. I mean, you have MTN is what? South Africa, and then you have Airtel, it's been all over the place. And in their particular countries where they come from, they have plans. They have mobile plans per person. You walk in and you say, okay, I want an Airtel line. And they're like, okay, so this is the plan we have. The Airtel line will come with this much data, this much airtime, you pay this much every month. Which is acceptable.
We had it here and we fought it.
Exactly.
I remember back in the time we had 25K.
No, but now, when you honestly look at it, because I think between us, we all have a friend who is already on a prepaid plan on their phone. I think it's about time that instead of just the whole ziwe deko, bula, dede, no, let's all go prepaid. It will teach us how to
kwebala. There are people who can't afford the prepaid.
And to chitegera. When we are doing prepaid, we are not going to do it on those other levels. This is Uganda. Prepaid, they have again, for 2 weeks. For 1 month. You get the drift. So that omuntabera chimanyi. Guno mwezi gwonna. Just like the way you use cable TV. I'm going to use cable TV. When my time is done, they will give me a warning and they're like, hey yo, your voice calls, your messages, your this and this and this is about to expire. Do you want to renew? Because then there, I believe, tatujoku yomba nyu. Because you'll know I have my data, it's for a month. I have my calls, they're for a month. If I use them Labalarias, which is almost impossible because usually the company has to send you a bill if you supersede your plan.
But they will argue you out and say they've done this. I mean, you have monthly bundles, and I think Airtel does it when they give you data bundles and voice bundles and SMSs,
and SMSs,
and you pay this kind of money. Mm-hmm. They're trying to push it there, but the people in the free market would want it to be a free thing. That if I want voice bundles, ndiwa dembogula voice bundles are coming as ziguako wenjagari. Not
yeah.
And because it's going to cut across when you say I'm giving you 1K, you're giving me 100 minutes. Why should you say that these 100 minutes expire, you know, in 24 hours? Why? Yet I've given you my 1K. You understand? So another person from the business point of view is going to say, but when you give me your 1K, I spend it and it's gone. So why don't you want to, you know,
use your
yes,
you got
there's
me.
An element of time in it. So I think that we need to have an objective conversation where the client is not squeezed, but also the service providers are not squeezed.
And I think
but
the
I
only reason
think,
why
do you
we
think
are
that
squeezed.
This petition could lead to that? Do you
no,
see?
No, I think the only reason why we are squeezed,
it,
Willis.
It's the, when, they, when he uses the word greed in the petition,
the
he
combo.
Just pushes the conversation ahead. So it takes longer because now you're going to start, people are going to start
but you
with,
see,
they won't come with men on their hats when they're having the conversation.
No, Willis, the thing though is, yes, what you're saying is really sustainable. It's a good idea. But knowing us as a nation, even if they go and petition and do all these things, people are still going to now complain. I think the conversation should be rerouted to, is it worth your money's worth? Is it worth when I buy my 1K data? Does it really do what's worth 1K? Because I think that's why we're calling them greedy. You go out, you buy your 7GB, you want to use your 7GB for the amount, they have, the time they've given. But then you run into life crazies and all of that. Never zisala. Ngatozi koze seza. So oliaba echimuluma. Kasente keke ya kozeji.
Okay.
So I believe the conversation should first start with, I'm sorry, I'm going to say this, with the government. We need to sub, we need to make sure we have particular amounts. You see, like how other countries, even just Kenya here, tebasusa certain amounts. Data wawa not tasuka wano.
Data wa Kenya are expensive, by the
yes.
way, compared
calls
to Uganda
no
data.
When you go to into the service conversation, you're going to have to increase the fee somewhere.
The fee somehow.
Are you serious?
Yeah, the fee has to increase somewhere. But
Kenya.
I want them cut.
For me, I think that the 3 days, when the com companies give us this data, they also put into consideration how much, you know,
life
client,
is coming at us.
Yeah, how much? No, how much you can, how long you can spend with a 1GB, and I don't think that you know, you can spend more than 2 days. Usually, when you put on that card GB, it takes about
2 days.
It's done. The third day is just for 100 MBs WhatsApp. And
yeah, that's true.
But you know, the conversation should shift to okay. I bought my car 1GB. Let me, if I want to use it until I die, it's okay. I want to use it just for WhatsApp.
Get in touch with us, and of course, let us know on your thoughts. What do you think about this new petition? And do you believe that actually your data bundles should expire, or when you load your car 1GB for 3 days, you can use it even for the entire week? And definitely, we'll get into that feedback a little bit later on. We're going for a very quick break, but when we do get back, it will be the second hour of the show, and we kick it off with the love letter.